Peace family, so I'm gonna try to make this video as short as I can because this video is directed towards the brothers, and I know that men tend to digest information a little bit better when it is straight and direct to the point. So in my last video, I talked about sisters with unrealistic standards and expectations. In this video, I'm going to be talking about brothers with low standards. Aside from feminism, the other main reason why so many sisters feel like they are entitled to a treatment and a praise that they are not deserving of, and that they feel like everyone should worship the ground they walk on, and that the only thing that they need to bring to the table is their looks and their yoni, is because there are so many brothers out there with low standards that are allowing them to believe that. There are so many brothers out there with low standards that don't require anything other than yoni and good looks from women, if the looks are even that good. There's so many yes men out there that kiss women's butt and don't require anything from them. You have to have higher standards, you know, and it is not just about the respect and the loyalty and the support and the nurturing and the femininity. It's not just about that. It's also about, what is she doing with her life? Does she have any goals? Is she a homemaker? Is she passionate? Does she get along with other women, or is she one of those I don't get along with other women type of sisters? Does she take care of herself, or is she one of those take me as I am type of sisters? What standards does she have for herself? What type of mother is she? What type of friend is she? You need to have these standards. Does she have any morals or principles? Does she know how to communicate? Does she apologize when she's wrong? You know, all of this stuff should be standards. These are basic standards that any man should have when choosing a woman. But some of you don't make it a requirement. You don't even care. And I'm going to give you a few examples of the way that some of you do this. The first way is through social media. Now, you know, a lot of women use social media platforms to gain attention and validation and to get that false sense of confidence, to get that boost of confidence that's not really real. And then they turn around and use that false sense of confidence to treat you like you are not on their level. They use that false sense of confidence to treat you like you are not good enough and like they are better than you in some way. So you see a sister posting a picture of her butt, her breasts, or whatever, and that's literally all she ever posts. You don't see her talking about nothing else. She ain't teaching nothing. She's not passionate about nothing. She's not sharing her talents with you, her goals with you, any other interests, just her butt, just her hips, her thighs. That's all you see, and you immediately give it your attention. You immediately give her that validation. You immediately give her that false sense of confidence. Did it ever occur to you that you are giving her the ammo that she needs to make you feel like you are not good enough for her? Because that's what a lot of sisters do. And I'm not saying that you can't like what you're attracted to. That's not what I'm saying. But make sure you are putting that same energy into other sisters. Because I see sisters all the time sharing their artwork or their music or whatever their craft is, something that they are interested in, showing that they are passionate about something other than money and attention, and that they have some sense of femininity. Because to be creative and to be in tune with that sensual side of yourself, to be vulnerable and share that with the world, you have to have some sense of femininity in you. I see some sisters that they might be plus size sisters that are sharing their journey in the gym, and they might not have reached their fitness goals yet, but they're at least showing that they're at least trying, they're working on their goals, they're in the gym, you know. And they get nothing, no love. So many of these sisters that are passionate and are doing other things, they get no love, they get no attention. But then the women that really don't need a lot of extra attention, you give it all to them. You give so much energy to these women that have nothing else to offer but their looks. And then you get mad when they think that that's all they need to offer is their looks. That's kind of backwards. So that's the first way y'all do it. Another way that y'all do it is when y'all always talking about the hitting and the quitting and the pumping and the dumping. Some of y'all say that with such conviction and such pride. And y'all say it in my comments all the time. That's why I just hit and quit. That's why I just pump and dump. And I know that to you all, it sounds good, but to me, it sounds like, yeah, I put my rod inside of a woman, or I lay down next to a woman that I don't feel is on my level. I lay down and I give a part of myself to a woman that doesn't even meet my standards and requirements. She really is not good enough for me, but I'm gonna give her some of me anyway. What does that really say about you? What does that really say about how you feel about yourself? What you gotta understand, brothers, is that during intimacy, men give their life force. You literally give your life force. As women, we take it. You know, that's why a lot of you feel depleted and drained, and you suffer in silence and depression. You don't know why, because you feel like you're doing everything right. But a lot of times it's because you're giving your life force and you're giving all this energy, but you are not making it a requirement for women to reciprocate energy in any type of way. They're not pouring any of that positive energy back into you. They're not being made to respect you. They're not being made to be your peace of mind. They're not being made to do any of that. All they have to do is just be cute, if they are, and have a yoni, and they get energy from you. They get to take from you, and you don't ask for anything in return. That is having low standards. That is having low standards for yourself. And if you want this to change, these unrealistic standards that sisters have, if you want to change at all, you have to raise your standards some. Because the more you are yes men to them and you come off as though you're desperate, or as though we are better than you in some type of way, because that's really what you're saying, is like you're not really deserving of anything better. You'll just tolerate the nonsense. Then you're just going to keep getting this treatment. Women are going to continue to mistreat you. Another way that men do this is when you don't make it a requirement for women to treat you good. Like, you just allow women to say anything to you. You could be 30 something years old, paying bills and everything, and will allow a woman to look you in your face and call you a boy. You know what I mean? You let women yell at you and talk over you, and then you just tolerate it, and you don't end the relationship. You don't give them no warnings, no ultimatums, no nothing. It's just like it never happened. Like, oh yeah, she talks to me like that, it's okay. You know, that's not okay. You know, and it's unfortunate, because I know that there are a lot of brothers out there that didn't get certain things from their mother, so they really don't even know what requirements and standards they should have from women, because you didn't get it from your own mother. And it's sad, but you cannot continue to tolerate these toxic traits from women and think that it's going to change. However things start in the beginning in your relationship, that's how it's going to go. You know, you are setting the standard in the beginning. So if in the beginning you are allowing a woman to mistreat you and talk to you like a boy and like you're a child, she can scream at you, cuss at you, call you a nigga, a boy, and all that stuff, and you just allow it to happen, it's going to happen for the remainder of your relationship. And I think that a lot of this should be kind of common sense, because you see what some of these women are out here teaching. They're telling other women to raise their standards and to not give men any play at all if they don't meet these standards. But men, on the other hand, a lot of them are just like, oh, they don't have to really meet our standards. We're just desperate for it. We just really want women, so we'll just take them exactly as they are, and we're not going to ask them to do anything different. You know, you can talk to me however you want to, you know, you'll still get my attention, you'll still get my energy, you know, and that's not okay. And another issue, outside of sisters having unrealistic expectations and unrealistic standards, another reason why you might want to raise your standards as far as women having more than just looks to offer is because you know who puts the most time, effort, and energy into their appearance? You know who puts the most energy into making sure their skin looks good and their makeup is perfect and their hair and their nail is perfect and their breasts look good and their butt looks good and their hips look good? And you know who puts the most energy and effort and time into that? Trannies. That's right. Yeah. So if I were you, I'd be careful, because I wouldn't be surprised if some of you haven't already ran through a couple of them. Since you're just pumping and dumping and hitting and quitting, all of a sudden it don't sound too good, does it? So I really think that you should have more standards, because again, if that's all that it takes for a woman to get your attention, to get your energy, then you are going to forever be mistreated. You are going to forever be looked down. You're going to forever be told that you are not on some woman's level, because it doesn't take much for women to look better. Nowadays, women can put on body shapers, they can put on makeup, they can put in weave, they can do all this stuff to make themselves look better. And you know, most of us are born with yoni, so there isn't much that is required there, you know. So basically you're telling us that many of us are born with everything it takes to get something from you. That's all it takes. I mean, I don't want to continue. I said I was going to try to keep it short, so I'm going to stop right here. But I really hope that some of you take this into consideration. Please raise your standards and hopefully you will be able to change the way you are seen and treated by sisters. So that's all I have to say. Peace and much love.